What the?
I spent more money on you, sir.
Yes, you did.
Jesus.
Did he say that?
Did he say that out loud?
Okay, I have another one.
Could you give Ernie a space? Doug, could you move that chair so they've got a space to look in through that window there? Okay, can we just try one more rehearsal, please?
And you mama! In around, let's go. In around.
Don't touch it.
You're coming out of the
door. Okay, let's do it. We ready now?
Here we go, rehearsal's on.
Okay.
Am I sitting?
You're already sitting up. You're sitting,
so
I don't think you can with that.
So the light have to come in the light.
Okay. Quiet, please. And rehearsal. And action.
Ah, here you are.
Hey! Jesus!
Sorry.
Action, Ernie.
Pal's here.
Hi, Bill. How you doing, pal?
Right.
I haven't seen you since last year.
This time last year. Love's Abiding Joy.
Are we going to be doing any more of them? No, you're going to do an acting one.
I'm not doing any more of that crap.
We're Lifetime.
Lifetime?
Lifetime.
Yeah.
I'd hang by the gear. That way if she radios something to you, you can pass it to her.
Is Drew set up?
Not yet. Almost.
You got a place to put everything? To work.
Hey, I'm working hard.
Susan, can you grab Don for us? Susan?
Don?
I'm sorry.
Don.
There he is.
Where are you
going? Don? There's the one.
Yeah. Okay, so Catherine, you're going to be more over here.
Special effects! Okay, let's offer it up, guys. Special effects, anybody around special effects?
Yeah.
Let me turn that heat off for a while.
Turn it off for a while?
Yeah, Al, buddy, turn it off.
Turn it off?
Yep. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thanks. You know, you were his favorite bad guy.
I'll do it now. No, it's okay.
Al told me you were his favorite doing, bad guy.
Barcelona. Yeah.
He's on the Al, you told me that Ernie was his favorite bad guy.
I got it. Watch this.
Where's Richard?
You can do it anyway.
Where's Richard?
Well, I just had the pleasure of the weekend looking through this group. You know, just sort of IMDb-ing and reminding myself of all the fun things you guys have done. Dying, what collection!
You found this out.
Can you step on your
mark? I've had some of those.
Todd,
one just reappeared online from when I was about 20. I think it was the first movie I did when I was about 23.
Yeah, there's three playing right now.
And it was a terrible movie that reappeared.
You'd be in this business for a long time and that'd be a terrible thing.
I love this company.
First people talking to their sweatshirts.
And it was the script.
And I tried to get the frame like
that's great company. People talking in their sweatshirts.
Sir Brian, my predecessor.
Yeah, Richard, can you take a look at
it's actually the CIA.
Yeah. And I read the script. My son had a bet. My engine tried to get me out. Funny thing is, it was so bad, he won so many of those. He'd never won a game where anybody saw him.
Ever.
You weren't here when we did McBride?
Nope. Never came out.
God, we were here one time when it was raining, man. It was pretty ugly.
Is there stuff coming in through that hole? In the dining room?
I have to be on the far side just in case, huh?
Once you come in the door, the shot is finished because she'll be looking the wrong side.
I know it.
See you later, y'all.
Donna Minchie one time over at Cumberland Central Park. You know, you ever hear Donna Minchie?
Yeah.
He was the biggest star they had, man. He was
big.
And one day he didn't feel like working, so he came in and he turned the hose on the whole lot set.
Water hose? Yeah.
Yeah, water hose. And he said, "Then get it fixed." It's just called.
Just like
he
that.
He went home.
Striking.
Nobody said a word. Nobody said nothing.
1916, it says, the set of Babylon built by Griffith for Intolerance. Look how good that, that set is.
Sure. Oh, yeah.
That is crazy.
Oh, man, that is amazing.
Oh, that's
and
the funny
these
one.
When they did Samson and Delilah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Victor Mature.
Oh, yeah.
Pushed them goddamn things up, and the whole thing tumbled down and everybody got killed.
What?
Remember the giving it over?
Yeah.
That Samson and Delilah?
Oh. Oscar Marty? From Marty. Signed it for me. Isn't that cool?
That is so...
That's nice.
You're the man, Ernie.
Oh, hey, yeah.
You talked about how much... So, Mark, I worked on Fox when I focused 5 years. Something how big the lot used to be. I didn't know that. I had no idea.
That's right.
Until the Greeks sold it, it became Century City.
Yeah, oh, okay.
I shot one of the big theatricals down there with Victor Mature and Susan Hayward.
Yeah.
And we shot it right down there in the corner, which is now Little Santa Monica and a big driveway that goes right up the hotel. It goes up through to the hotel.
It's called Hollywood. She's got a bunch of photos. Of
why don't you do everything and he'll make the book?
Yeah, yeah. From the, talks about the...
Get that picture of Ernest again. That is...
And then, one thing about being a guy, you get better looking as you get older. And you look good then, so it means you're better looking now.
Oh. God. I have a picture at home when I was 16. Man, I was a good-looking chick. I said, at that time, yeah. Since then, I changed. Just like I said here in this picture, you know, I said, they took one look at this face and gave me a heavy. This one, this, I said, this is John Gilbert. I mean, he was a star of the first water in silent pictures. But because they couldn't handle sound like they do today, he had a high pitched voice like this. Did you know that? He was out. That's all there was to it. The same thing with Clark Gable, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Clark had a voice like this, you know. Clark Gable. We're talking about Clark Gable. And his wife used to tell him, "For Christ's sake, talk like a man." I said, "Oh, yes, I forgot it."
Oh, right here somewhere.
That Daryl Zanuck right there. what an actor he was. The old man.
The security guys at Fox showed me some underground, like, tunnels they used to have under the studio.
That's John Barrymore.
Barrymore, yeah.
And that's the girl that married Clark Gable. What's her name?
Carol Lombard.
Carol Lombard. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
That's right. She was the one that got killed in an airplane accident. He never recovered from that. He just went to hell after that.
And John Barrymore.
And
Harvey, double check the frames.
Catherine, come on out.
Let's squeeze down on that. That's way too hot. Squeeze down.
She's camera left, eh? So guys, you're right here. So you're gonna start here.
Is that right?
And my prop is here.
Yeah.
Larry Frank!
Hey, puppet.
Oh, that is funny.
His head's all black from the chimney. It's our job, buddy.
It's okay. Come on, buddy.
What if he's got a leg going down?
I'm talking to the producer who sees what we're doing. He's telling me to get Santa's face out of the chimney.
Really?
I said that on camera. You're spying on us now, I know. Okay, group photo on top of the house. How's that?
Well, duh. Yeah, have you heard anybody say that?
No.
In real life? Well, duh.
No.
I haven't.
Well, yeah, they say, well, duh.
That's what I mean.
Kids say that.
Kids say that.
Yeah.
Well, duh.
Is that in the script?
Yeah.
Huh.
What are you shooting? A motion picture over there or what?
It's a character study of Ernest Borgnine.
Oh my God, wait till I take my glasses off. Holy cow.
Watch out, Bill, coming through.
Actually, this is for my mom.
I'll do it only if the
points.
Game pitches in.
Points.
Mom, don't believe a word of it.
Her name's Dorothy.
Dorothy, please don't believe a word of it. Honest. I'm doing this under duress. Spelled I-N-N-O-C-E-N-T.
So here it is, Christmas hike. Santa's got the presents here.
I want the green one.
Green one, it's got your name on it.
Thank you.
The only way it really works is when you get the other people working against you.
Of the other actors, you have to have the other
You know
actors.
What I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, it helps. It helps. Don't get me wrong. But you can get the whole script in your head, and then somebody says, "Okay, we're going to shoot it." Okay. Wait a minute. The guy didn't sound like that. Don Rickles one time was a good one. We were studying for the Odd Couple. He and I did the Odd Couple together.
Oh.
2 weeks up in San Francisco and 2 weeks down at Disneyland.
Oh, okay.
And so we were rehearsing with this, that, and the other thing. Where's the kid's telephone? Wait a minute, where's the tricycle here? We're using. Where's the little chair?
So it threw them all off, huh?
Threw them all off. And the very first night we opened, I'll never forget, we were working in the round. And he was supposed to go, come in and make that turn, you know? And instead of that, he started right for me. You know, I went halfway, I grabbed him, I said, Felix, what's the matter? What happened? He said, Oh, I'm sorry. And bam, he became Felix. We were told by a writer, Neil Simon.
Neil Simon, yeah.
He said, of all the people that have played this, he said, you two are the only ones that played it the way I wanted it played.
How interesting.
Not for laughs, but truly from the heart, you know? Yeah. That's the only way it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Truly from the heart. There's everything in it, you know?
Yeah.
But it plays, I have seen comedians go up there and try to make a laugh, make it laugh. And it falls flat on its face because it's there, the laughs are there. All you have to do is play it honestly. So that's the way we played it, and boy, he just couldn't get over it. He said, that's marvelous. And we had all kinds of people come up to visit us, you know? Because he wasn't as well known then as he is now. Comedy is never played for comedy. You play it with that you know, honesty. That's where the comedy comes from the being honest. Yeah. No, it's been fun. It really has.
What was Tim Conway like to work with? I like Tim Conway.
He's the quietest fellow you've ever met in your life.
He's introverted.
Until he hears the whir of the motors.
Oh.
Then he becomes alive. Up until then, you don't even know he's alive.
Oh, he's real meek and shy.
Meek, doesn't say a word. No. Hello, how are you? That's
it. And he's kind of introverted.
You hear the whir of the motors, man, he turns it on. I was walking along Broadway one time. Not Broadway, 10th Avenue. And I'm saying to myself, dummy, why did you ever become an actor? You can only work once a month. Because they didn't want to see your face all the time on television.
Oh.
And it was terrible because, I knew I had the ability, and people knew it, but they couldn't use me.
You couldn't find the
right. Fact that, you know, hey, you can't. And suddenly I smelled somebody, some vendor up in New York City, you know, selling hot chestnuts. And I walked up a little closer, not to buy any because I didn't have money to buy a chestnut. But just the smell.
That was cool.
And I saw a sign on a vendor's cart that became my philosophy of life. And it read, I don't want to set the world on fire, I just want to keep my nuts warm.
Oh, that's hilarious. I'm going to look for you, Bob.
This is 2007, Hollatch Boy, Bert and Becca, right here on the McBride set. Dog, we hit it hard in this one, man. We got a Christmas story going on, we got people singing, pop musical. Dog, it's off the hook, man. This guy's off the hook right here.
Now the Japanese are pushing.
Here, Bill, give a shout out to my boys out there. Yeah, that's right. Oh, right at the nose, baby.
Did you tell Houston? Might have got a problem. Tomorrow?
Ernie, did you?
Marie needs last
there we come. Taking pictures of us. Good God Almighty. This is the drunken version.
You didn't call Martini Tiny, did you?
Not yet.
Yeah.
Is he talking out there? I can hear
Martini. Not to us.
Martini, my God. We haven't even started yet. Are you kidding me?
Way back.
Okay, we're roll sound.
We're rolling sound.
Sound speeding.
They should just play.
There you
go. Playback.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year.
And sell it back to us
add
for big money.
Add insult to injury. Playback.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. Christmas and a happy new year. We're tidings, glad tidings to you and your kin. We're tidings for Christmas and a happy new year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
If he can screw you up, you watch Ernie, he'll screw you up.
You're in the shotgun.
Lens flare. Lens flare. Can we get a flag? I feel so dirty right now.
Okay,
now do something nasty.
I need some music or something.
That's a lot of pressure for a guy.
Hey Art, how's it going?